Welcome to the Discovering SystemVue video series. In this tutorial, we'll explore creating an IBIS AMI model. Here I've opened the PCI Express Generation 2 example that is shipped with the product. We're looking at the top-level schematic, and in this top-level schematic, we have bits, and these are pseudorandom bits, going into a pulse-shaping component. This pulse-shaping component takes the bits and creates a bit waveform with a user-specified number of samples per unit interval. This is then fed into the PCI Express subnetwork design, which we'll be using to not only simulate but also generate our IBIS AMI model. We'll explore the subnetwork momentarily. The bit waveform is then outputted from the subnetwork model and then fed into the FlexDCA sync. The FlexDCA sync allows us to analyze the outputted bit waveform from the transmitter using Agilent instrument software. Let's explore the subnetwork model. Here is the PCI Express transmitter. We've implemented an FFE, and then we also have an S-domain filter, which allows us to shape the waveform. The subnetwork has a number of parameters. These parameters are then used in equations in the subnetwork, and these equations set internal variables which are used to configure the behavior of the schematic. Let's simulate the design. When we simulate the design, the FlexDCA software automatically opens. This FlexDCA instrument interface allows us to use and measure anything that you could in an Agilent oscilloscope. So for example, I'm able to look at the rise time by clicking a button. I'm also able to explore the eye amplitude and many other measurements. In addition, we're also able to look at the time waveform. To do that, you go and switch from eye mask mode to oscilloscope mode, and you see the transmitted time waveform. I'm zooming out on the signal, and you can see the de-emphasis here. So let's explore what different de-emphasis settings do to the transmitted waveform. To do that, we'll go back to SystemVue and use the slider to change the de-emphasis. So here I am increasing the de-emphasis of the waveform, and as you can see, as I move the slider, the de-emphasis gets bigger. I can also go in and decrease the de-emphasis, and as I go and decrease it, the waveform also changes. Once we have verified the design and the behavior of the transmitter model, we're ready to generate an IBIS AMI model. I've instantiated code generator here and configured it to export the transmitter. To configure it, what you do is you first point to the top-level design, in this case it's Simulate TX, and then you add each subnetwork that you want to export. Here we've added the PCI Express transmitter. To add, all you have to do is click Add, and when you click Add, you see the complete hierarchy of the system. To select it, all you do is put a checkmark box and add it. Once you've added the different subnetworks, you're ready to go and configure each subnetwork. Here we only have one subnetwork selected, which is PCI Express, and we've configured it below. We've declared that it is an LTI system and is a transmitter model. Additionally, we've tied a few of the AMI init arguments, such as bit time and samples per bit, to the subnetwork parameters. Additionally, we have one model-specific parameter, which is the de-emphasis, and we've chosen to export it. Once we've configured the system, we hit Generate Now to generate the code. Visual Studio automatically opens and lets us compile the generated AMI model. As you can see, it just takes a few seconds. Now we have an IBIS AMI model ready to be used in a channel simulator. I encourage you to continue exploring the other examples for IBIS AMI that are shipped with SystemVue.